race here. How do you feel coming in?
I'm pretty excited. I haven't raced the Nationals at MX2, so I'm a little nervous. Well, not nervous, but I'm anxious to see what's going on with the pace of the other MX2 riders. It's a shorter moto, so it's more of a sprint, which I need to get used to. I need to try to figure out today. But I mean, I really like this track. I've had some good results here in the past, so I'm pretty confident coming into this race.
You're riding a KTM two-stroke rather than the four-stroke. You think it'll be an advantage in the sand?
Yeah, definitely here with the deep sand. I think the four-strokes struggle a little bit. It's definitely an advantage for me. I'm a little bit bigger than those other guys. I got a few more pounds on them, so I need that extra power to get me up on top of the sand and get going quicker.
You've been tearing up the Ontario circuit in the first few months of the season. What result today would make you happy?
My goal is top five. I think I'm capable of top five. I just really have to get good starts and be consistent. Fitness is a big factor here at the Gopher Dunes and the rough track and the heat. So I know my fitness is good. So I definitely think I should be a top five contender.
Well, good luck today, and we're gonna check you out all day and follow you around.
First practice went well. I went out and did a quick lap time as third. I know it's only practice, so qualifying will probably change. But it was pretty smooth out there, not really many lines formed. So I think it'll definitely be a lot better in qualifying. I like it when it gets a little rougher and there's some bumps and some lines in. It separates the guys a little bit more, and I think I can probably do a pretty good time in qualifying.
About 40 minutes away from the first MX2 moto. You qualified pretty well. You looked good in practice. How'd you feel?
I felt pretty good. The first practice, I felt a little bit better than the second practice. I mean, we're going to make a few suspension changes. I think I just may be a bit too fast and rebound, but I think I found a good setup now. Track starting to form some lines. I didn't read the lines properly. I think I went to the rougher lines. I got to use this hot lap and find the smoother lines. Definitely for the heat and the long moto. So I'll look for the smooth lines, and I think I can just find some more flow, especially on the two-stroke. It's best to just keep the momentum up everywhere, and I need to try to figure that out. I think it'll be a good race.
Not alone. just like me, you. And I know you too. Mr. Perfect don't exist, my little friend. And I tell you it all again. And I do it again. Counting all the in the room. Well, I'm definitely not alone. Well, I'm not alone. Yeah.
First moto went well. Well, not the greatest. My start wasn't the greatest. I kind of spun off the gate, but the first lap I was kind of next to Muffinbar, which I mean he finished pretty well up there. But I got caught up in one of the pileups and it cost me a lot of positions. I think I got first lap. I think I came around 39th, and then second lap I slid out and collided with Jeremy Medaglia, and I went down. So that cost me a few more positions, but. Found my groove and I came back to 8th. So I was pretty happy with that, but I was a little disappointed with the way everything went. Second moto, I got a good start. I was top 10, I think I was 6th actually. And about 3 laps in, I'm not sure who was in front of me, Pierce I think. I don't know, he's an American guy. And I knifed the front end and went over the bars. It didn't feel like a big crash, but I landed on my shoulder, just in the right spot. I felt a little bit of pain, but I got up instantly and tried to carry on, but when I went through the rollers at the back, I felt the pain instantly. I felt some clicking in my shoulder, so I pulled off and went to the medics. And I haven't got it checked out yet. We'll probably go check it out this week. I'm just going to keep some ice on it and keep the swelling down. And I'm hoping it's just a minor injury. Hoping it's a 2 or 3 week injury and I can be back for Deschambault or Moncton. So we'll see.
Let's go! Come on, make some noise, everybody!